Good morning to all of you. It is a moment of extreme pleasure for me to welcome our eminent speaker, Mr. Debashish Ghosh, in the webinar. On behalf of the Himalayan Institute of Technology, I thank you, sir, for accepting our invitation for the webinar. It is an honor for all of us to have such a great personality among us. We are all keen to hear from you, sir, about your success, about your journey, knowledge, success mantras, basically. Thank you for taking out time for all of us from your busy schedule to share your thoughts with us. I'm sure it will definitely help our students to achieve successful career in their respective fields. Once again, I welcome you to the webinar, sir. I know that student gets bored very easily, and we all have to listen to this, sir. So I'll not take much time. Thank you very much, sir. And I hope that our association is going to be a very long one. And in coming future, we will be bothering you. We will be behind you to come time to time and guide our students by sharing your knowledge. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Director, ma'am. It is actually my pleasure and my privilege to be here. I was wondering the other day, why haven't I come to HIT before? But as they say, it is better late than never.
Now I'd like to request my co-host, Professor Shalini Kuchal, to please take this webinar forward.
Thank you, sir. Good morning, everyone. I'm Shalini Kuchal, your co-host for the day. I would like to welcome everyone to today's webinar session on How to Build Successful Careers by Mr. Debashish Ghosh. Mr. Ghosh is a human resource professional with over 18 years of experience in managing end-to-end functions in HR. Mr. Ghosh has successfully led the HR function managing clients and stakeholders across many industries like IT, financial services, pharma, manufacturing, logistics, retail, hospitality, and consumer goods. Throughout his journey, he has participated in and driven many transformational and organizational development initiatives. Mr. Ghosh is currently working as the Vice President and Country Head HR for Berkadia Berkshire Hathaway and Jefferies Financial Services Company prior to joining Berkadia. He was associated with GE and Genpact, managing multiple roles in HR. Mr. Ghosh is an executive alumnus of IIM Calcutta and a Marshall Goldsmith certified executive and team coach. Mr. Ghosh is also a certified practitioner of several behavior and personality assessment tools. In addition to it, he is also a certified NLP practitioner as well, awarded by the International NLP Association. Mr. Ghosh has been awarded with two of the most prestigious HR credential in the world, Senior Certified Professional from Society of Human Resource Management and Global Talent Management Leader from Talent Management Institute. Recently, Mr. Ghosh has been recognized by the Silicon India magazine as one of the top 10 most promising HR leaders 2020 and as India's 50 best HR leaders 2021 by White Page International. Under his able HR leadership, Berkadia was recognized with the Employer of Choice Award 2020 by the Indian Corporate Award 2020 for values and practices contributing to an enjoyable workplace. Mr. Ghosh is also an official mentor and advisor to several universities and B schools. In 2020 itself, he has given lectures, mentored students, and conducted workshops at more than 50 business schools, including IIMs, on the latest trends impacting HR and organization. At the personal front, Mr. Ghosh is an avid reader and a traveler. It is my honor and privilege to welcome Mr. Debashish Ghosh. Now, I would like to invite Mr. Debashish Ghosh.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am, and thank you for that wonderful introduction. Yeah, it's been about 20 years of journey, so I would speak a little bit about what my learning has been. Archana ma'am, you said that what has been my experience and learning from my own experience and also from the experience of people that I worked with. I've been very fortunate to work with some wonderful leaders who have coached, guided me. I have also worked with me. It is something from them. And this might not be from the textbook typically. This is my own personal learnings. And this is something that I would want to share. When I share this, I also share the perspective of the fact that I'm also an HR leader. I'm also a recruiter. So when I come to colleges like HIT and look at new students, what are the skills I look at? Will I hire them? Right. So keeping everything in mind, I'm going to share some of my thoughts about how can we build successful careers. And I have made a small presentation for everyone, for the students. I'll share that as I speak. And I think I'll probably take about 30, 40 minutes and try to move fast because it is a virtual world. People really get bored, as you said. And I would love to come back and take any questions on the presentation or anything else that the students have questions on. Great. So let me start with the presentation. Let me share my screen. Okay, so I'm going to talk about in my 21, 22 years of career, what are the five learnings I had from experience, which I believe is very important for anyone to build careers. There can be six, there could be seven, there could be 10, there could be 15 as well. But I think these five are non-negotiable, which I have seen common in me and also various leaders, as I mentioned, I have worked with. Now, all these five, my dear students, are not in a particular order. So what I mean by that is that it is not that what I show the first one is the most important. What is number five is the least important. All of these are equally important, right? So without much ado, let me start sharing some of these. And it's probably a question. And because we cannot chat right now, so I will probably request you to reflect on it for a few seconds on some of the questions that I'll ask you, right? Very simple question. All of you are very, very adept in using, social networking site. I'm sure you are much better students than us, like Mr. Singh or Archana ma'am, because you are very good in using social networking site, right? Which are the top three or four social networking site of yours, the favorite ones? Just take 15 seconds and think about it. Your favorite social networking site, which you are active on. I'll give an example. You might like TikTok, for example, but if you're not using TikTok, you're not active on that, then you might not take that, right? But if you're active on, say, Instagram, then it becomes one of your part of a list. So 15 seconds, what are your two or three most important or favorite social media sites? And you can take some examples. This is just examples that you can think about. It is not an exhaustive list. There are a lot more, but these are the common ones that I know. I don't use all of these, but I know some of these that you use. I'm not speaking to you. I do not know what you've written in your book or in your head, what you're thinking about. But going by what my experience is of talking to many of my employees and youngsters and also college students, there are four or five very common social networking sites that we and all the youngsters of these days we use. So some of these are very common that comes up in all the polling that I do, right? Facebook comes up very common, Instagram, Twitter, WhatsApp, and YouTube. Very, very common. On the top five or six, I see this in all the list. However, and this is my first lesson, okay? There is one particular social network site which I want to see more often in your list, but I do not see it more often. And that is LinkedIn. If you are a student, if you are a job seeker, if you are someone who is at any stage of your career, whether you're starting your career, whether you're a mid-stage of your career, right? It is absolutely important. If you do not do anything else, just do LinkedIn. Because LinkedIn at this point is the only professional social networking site. One of the biggest lessons I have learned in my professional career is networking, right? As you grow more in your career, you actually get great roles, great jobs only because you know some good people and they will help you with your career journey. Without networking, you cannot do anything. It's so very important thing, right? And LinkedIn one of the limitations is that networking earlier used to happen only with the people who have physical proximity. So you know somebody, you can go and talk to them, you know, you know the person, walk up to the person. But now, thanks to LinkedIn, you and I do not know how many students are there in this particular webinar, but if there are 200, today, you and I, all 200 and Debashish can be connected. You and I are networked. This opportunity was not there previously. All right. And secondly, LinkedIn is going to be the biggest job site very, very soon. It is going to overtake Naukri.com. So if you want to get good jobs, right, you have to make sure that you are your LinkedIn profile is updated and you also networked. You are connected with, you know, people, not only me, but people like me around the world so that if they can help you in a guide your career, right? So that is one very, very important thing. This is something I learned very late in my life. I actually started getting active like 5 or 6 years before, and I wish I was active earlier. So do not make the mistake that I did. Get into LinkedIn and get networked. I would love to be in touch with you through LinkedIn. So if you are already have an account, you can follow me. I love to follow you as well. So please do that and you can stay connected forever, right? Connection starts from right now at this moment between you and me. It will go lifelong. All right. So that's the power of connection. So build your professional brand. There is nothing wrong absolutely about being in you know, Twitter or being in Instagram, being in Facebook. That is your personal brand. Of course, you are somebody outside of your work as well. Very important. But professional brand is equally important, if not more, if you want to build your career. Okay, that's the first lesson I have for you, or first learning I have for you, is this: be active on LinkedIn, build your professional brand. Right. And there are different ways we can do it, being professional, but that is something I'll discuss probably some other time, how to be very, very strong brands that attract employers to you, right? So that is a different discussion for some other day. Another question that you should, that's a first, lesson. The second lesson I'm coming to right now, okay? A lot of students ask me, or they have in their mind about something like a dream job. Okay, so this is my dream job. This is how I want it to be. This is my dream company, right? This is how I want my dream company to be, right? But what really is this dream job and this dream company? What do I really expect from a dream company? What does my dream job look like? Right? It is possible that as you go in your career, as you move on, you will be encountered, you'll be facing a question like this. And this is a bit of a case study, okay? Suppose you, one of you, there are so many students there. By the way, Mr. Singh, how many students are there in the webinar today, approximately?
I'll tell you, I can see, I think it's when I started, there were only 215 students, but I was about to interrupt and inform you that I'm amazed to see that 300 students have joined.
That is excellent.
That is the magic of your voice, I suppose.
I'm very. It's a pleasure. I'm thankful for the students.
They are increasing. I can see the numbers.
That's good to know. That's good to know. So students, you will at some point, you might get a very, very nice problem like this, what you see on my screen. I'm saying nice problem because you see here sometimes you might get two offers. Now, you might not get that very often, by the way. I want to be realistic as well. But hypothetically, imagine that you are getting two offers from two different companies. The company names are ABC and XYZ, right? It can be Amazon or Facebook. It doesn't matter. Just imagine the company names are ABC and XYZ. Now, the question is, you have two offers, right? What factors will you consider before choosing whether you want to go for the ABC company or you want to go for the XYZ company? And for a moment, think it is your first job. You're not an experienced professional. You're just out of your college and you are got these two offers. How will you determine whether you want to choose ABC company and XYZ company? Just take 15 seconds and think about it. And I will tell you some of the things, answer that I get very, very often. There are many things, okay, that all of us look for. You know, the human needs are never, never ending, right? We always want more and more and more and more and more. So in our ideal job or in our ideal company, we look at all of these things. Of course, salary is very important, right? I'm not saying salary is not important, but role also becomes important, because imagine right now, remember, you have got two offers. Okay, so somebody is paying you more salary, you want to join, right? Typically, or somebody who might give you a better role, or some you really like that particular job, you might want to go for that. Sometimes you might want the like the culture of the company. You know, typically people, we all look up to a company called Tata. All of you know about Tata, right? They have a great culture. So sometimes their brand name and their culture are very strong. Some students might say, you know what, I can live with a less salary, but I want to join the Tatas. It is quite possible. And there is nothing wrong with that, absolutely. Right? Industry that the company belongs to. Some of us might have a preference about working for automobiles. Some of us have a preference of working in a hospitality company. You know, some of us in a financial services company. So while you might do a management course or a commerce course, for example, the industry can be different, right? So the ABC company is from automobiles, but XYZ is from financial services. You might want to work for the ABC company, right? And plus, there is, you will look at the aspect of career growth. What are the benefits that the employee provides to the employees? Is there a job security or not? Imagine working for a company which pays you the top salary, best of salaries, lekin kal ko job ka thikana nahi hai. Whether you might lose the job tomorrow, would you want to work for that company? Might be not, or might be. Might be you want to take that risk. And I'm not saying for a moment that any of these that you see on my screen is good or bad. It is your personal choice. I have not come here to give you any advice on the choices that you are making. And it should be a more of a personal choice than anything else. What I'm telling is that there are different options, there are different factors that you should look at in a dream job or a dream company. The only thing I'm going to tell you is that, and this is from my experience, no company that has ever existed or will ever exist in future which has all of these. When you get one thing from a company, you have to sacrifice something else. So you cannot say that, you know what, I need a company with the best salary, great culture, great leadership, job security, great benefits, great role. That company, I'm sorry, my dear friends and students, does not exist. It will never exist as well. So it's the choice you make when you make those career decisions. I'll tell you what choice I had made, because I had made this mistake in my past about expecting everything from a company. And I actually did not take a few very good offers because I felt, it doesn't give me everything. I'll tell you a small story about me. It was back in the year 2002, many years back. Right. I was working for a company called GE at that point. GE is a very big company, as you know. Right. One fine day, I received a call from a recruiter who was hiring. And he called me on my phone and said, can I speak to Debashish? I said, yeah, this is Debashish speaking. I said, are you looking for a job? We plan to hire you in our company. Frankly, I was not looking for a job at this point of time, but it is always nice to get a call from a recruiter, right? So I said, yeah, you know what? I'm not looking for a job, but you know what? If there's a good opportunity, I might consider. Which company are you calling from, by the way? That person said, I'm calling from a company called Google. And I, back 20 years back, I had no idea what is this company. I said, sorry, what? And it sound, the name sounded very funny to me. Google kya company ka naam ho sakta hai? Toh bachcho ka koi khilona lag raha hai. You know, I said, can you please repeat what you said? Can you spell the name of your company? He said, G-O-O-G-L-E. It is very funny name here. I didn't tell him, of course. I mean, Google is a very funny name. I said, sorry, you know. And with that name only, I decided, boss, mujhe toh karna nahi is company mein kaam. Right? Then I said, sorry, you know what? I'm not looking for a job, but thank you for the call. You know, so the point is that without knowing much, without thinking about much about what are the opportunities there, what is the role and everything, I just let go of an opportunity in working with Google. And I don't know if it was a good decision or a bad decision, okay? Because I actually did made a good career for myself so far. But life would have been very different if I had worked in Google back at this point of time, right? But I felt, you know, Google did not give me everything that I needed. I'll tell you what I choose as my top three factors when I choose my first job. Because dream job is not there, right? My factors were, and the factors were financial independence, job security, and to gain work experience. Again, in not any particular order, but all this was very important. So my primary goal was to earn my own money, because obviously my family could not support me, and there are different things are there. So I just wanted to earn a salary. That salary could be whatever. I didn't care. Okay. Secondly, because the job was important to me, job security was important to me. I did not want to lose my job in the next 1 month or 6 months. So the second factor I considered was job security. The third factor, which is very important for any fresher, is to gain work experience. Work experience, my dear students, is probably the most valuable thing you can gain while you are a fresher, while you are a new professional. 1 day of work experience matters a lot. The moment you get 1 day of work experience, people will stop asking you whether do you have an experience or not, right? This is very important. So all these three things are important for me. So what I did, a lot of you might not be aware that I actually have a degree in hotel management when I started. And I think HRT has a course in hotel management, right? Okay, all right. So I can connect, some of them can connect to me a lot better, but I'm a hotel management student. So when I passed out many years back, more than 20 years back, I was not getting any good job. I did a lot of these walk-ins. At that time, you know, this campus interviews weren't there. So the first job I did, my dear students, was a job of a waiter. So do not think that Debashish became a VP and country head of a Berkshire Hathaway company because he studied in a great business school like IIM Calcutta. That I did many years later. Or I started working in GE. I worked as a waiter in a small hotel in Vizag and in Andhra Pradesh for about 1 year. Then I worked as a bellboy in the same hotel. Bellboy are the people, the hotel management guys would know, they carry luggages when you check into a hotel and you get small tips. That time I used to get 5 rupees tips. I used to be very delighted with that. Why did I do that? Because these three things are important for me. I could have waited for 1 year, 2 years to get the job of a front office manager, but I would have lost my financial independence. I would have lost my work experience. And because of that work experience that I gained is what I am today. Okay. The second lesson that I want to share is that be clear about what you want from that job. Dream job does not exist. What you want from your job should be clear to you. It is very important to you, individual to you. Somebody might look for a good salary. Somebody might look for a higher designation, but that somebody is very different from you. You should determine what is important for you and stick to it. Okay, don't bother if you are getting a job for waiter. I'm sure you'll not get a job for waiter. You are much better and smarter than me. Of course, by the way, waiters are very, very smart. We'll talk about it sometime later. I'm not demeaning any job here because I have been one for 2 years of my life. They're very, very hardworking, very, very passionate people. But some people might not see, you know, their future in that. But it, you have to choose what is important for you and then go. That's the first, second lesson that I want to talk about. Third lesson, I don't know how many of you watch Hollywood movies, but there's one Hollywood movie I really like. I do not know if you have seen this movie or this poster rings a bell. This is a movie, this is a picture from a movie called The Intern. The Intern, I-N-T-E-R-N, The Intern. It is easily available on Netflix, and I think it's free on YouTube as well. Please see the movie. It's a very nice, small, short movie, very nice movie. About this guy on the left-hand side, little aged old guy called Ben Whitaker. So Ben Whitaker joins his company as a senior citizen. He had an experience before that, of course, but he gets hired into this company as an intern. You know, those short-term intern roles that we do. And how he does that, you know, interns typically are very young people, freshers out of college. So he's a very odd man now doing the role of an intern and working with people who are very younger to him. How does he go about with his interpersonal skills? How does he go about influencing and also managing that company, managing his boss, which is that young lady on the right-hand side? It's a very beautiful, movie. You must watch. It's a homework. Say, I gave a nice homework to you, watching movies. Weekend is coming up as well. So because this will tell you about what I believe is the job description of the 21st century, of all of you. Whether you're doing hotel management, whether you're doing agricultural science or you know, computer science or any management degree or commerce, and there are many things, I guess, it is taught in HIT. But what do we really look for as a, now I'm coming to me as a recruiter, right? What I really look for when I come to hire you is, what is this? It's very common, actually. It doesn't matter which stream you study. Of course, you'd be good in technical stuff, right? You have, if you're doing hotel management, you know what is housekeeping, food production, F&B service, and so on and so forth. If you're doing management, you know, finance, HR, accounting, and so on and so forth, right? So, but besides those technical skills, right, what I need from each one of you when I come to hire, I want you all to solve business problems for me, okay? Not your own areas or agricultural problems or you know, commerce problems. It is the problems of the company that it is facing as a company, okay? And solve this proactively, which means not reactively. Solve it not after it has happened, okay? If it has happened after, I can also solve. I don't need some bright students and young students like you to do that. You should be able to anticipate the problem and proactively solve it by creative means. Because see, old people like me, 20 years of experience, we're not creative. We think in the one straight line, linear way, right? We can't think differently, like out of the box, like you guys do. I want you all to think very creatively and proactively to solve my business problems. With artificial intelligence, the knowledge of technology is very important and knowledge of emotional intelligence is very, very important. So if someone has to ask me, sir, what do I have to do, right? Irrespective of what are you studying, this is something that every employer from any industry will be expecting from you to solve their problems proactively and creatively through technology and AI. So if you're doing agricultural science, you should also know what is the technology impacting agriculture. If you're doing hotel management, you must also know that how can you do automated check-in? You don't have to have a person to write and fill up a ledger to you, all right? So how can you do this with the help of AI? And also emotional intelligence talks about how good you are with your interpersonal skills and dealing with yourself and dealing with others, right? There is one slide I have. I don't want to spend too much time here because this is a discussion for a different day, okay? Because there are a lot of things here. If you have to, you know, do this, if this is the job description, these are the skills you require to do this job description, right? And if you see in the, you need to have the knowledge of the industry, knowledge of your own department, be it agriculture, which is the functional acumen, technical acumen, right? Of agriculture, hotel management, commerce, management, whatever, and put my finance, marketing there just as to a, just as an example. Plus, what is there in the middle is very important. I call it the CTC, not CTC like salary, cost to company. The C stands for is creative thinking, technology literacy, and consultative skills. If you have this CTC, if you focus on this CTC, if you're determined to learn about this CTC, I can assure you, my dear students, you'll be successful in whatever you do. It is irrespective of what you are studying. Okay, but again, if you see the four corners of EI, is like a gift wrap. Like it's like nicely, you know, you have to make sure that EI compasses everything. You have to very be good in dealing with people, building trust, interacting with people, interpersonal skills. Those things are also very, very important, right? But each one of these merits a discussion, at least another session. I don't want to spend too much time on this one, not for today. But these are something, and this is something you can take a picture on, or if you can, you know, keep it in your head. I'll be happy to share the slides as well if you all need it. Nothing I do, keep it for myself. It is for me to share everything that I know. So I'm happy to share the slides with you. But this is something that you must know. Therefore, the lesson number three that I have is that invest in building soft skills. So while you'll be building, you'll be learning about hotel management, technical side, agriculture, computer science and everything, management, all, but soft skills are equally important, okay? If not more important, because soft skills help you build your career, okay? Especially my focus for the students would be on building emotional intelligence. Because remember this, soft skills are the hard skills of tomorrow. There is nothing like a soft skill right now. You know, earlier EI is a good to have, right? If you do not have also, it is okay. But it is not good to have anymore. It's must to have. Similarly, creative thinking is must to have. Consultative skills is must to have. And this is not something you can only learn in a college, right? It is something that you have to learn, invest on as you keep growing on your career. Even today, I'm learning, my dear students, believe it or not, even today, right? All the things that I've, Shalini talked about in terms of my credentials and other things, it was not acquired in a day. Even today, I'm studying something. So this is very, very important, you know, invest on skills. And I call it a lifelong learning, LLL, three L's. Don't forget this. It's a lifelong learning. Keep investing in yourself. That's the third thing that I have seen. I do to myself all that I have seen. A lot of leaders do it to them all the time. Okay. That's the third one. I'm coming to the fourth one. I'll show some pictures of some organizations, their logos. And some of the logos are very, very well known to all of you. You know, I'm sure everybody can recognize WhatsApp, Uber, Airbnb, Instagram, and a lot of others. It's just a few. There are hundreds of those I could have put in there. You know what is common among these organizations? They're from different industry. They do different jobs. There are different, market segments and everything. What is common among these organizations is that these organizations did not exist 10 to 15 years back. It is like when this Google guy called me in 2002 and I was wondering, yeah, at least spell the name of your company, right? These companies did not exist 10 to 15 years back, okay? So, and I'll tell you why I'm talking about this, but, you know, it is quite possible that 10 years time, you'll be working for some companies, the students, which does not exist today. That's why, you know, so the students ask me, so which company should I join and which industry? I said, I don't know. I wish I was an astrologer. I wish I could see the 20 years down the line as to which industry will be bigger, which industry will be better, which company I should invest on. If somebody is saying, don't believe them, to be honest with you, nobody knows. History shows that this customer preferences changing, new industries coming up, new companies come up, we don't know. So if you do not know, then what do we do, right? Because one is that then the third one becomes very, very important, right? Invest in building your, you know, soft skills. That becomes very, very important because the soft skills are transferable skills. It is doing a bank job, right? I don't know if your parents have worked in a bank. They must have worked in Dehradun at some point, then worked with, going to Patiala, then went to Chandigarh. The skill is the same industry of father got transferred or your mom got transferred. So the soft skills are transferable skills. So you can take it to any company, right? So typically when you go to Google and you can type a career path, in the images, you'll see a picture like this. You'll also see some stairs, people walking upstairs and so on and so forth, okay? This, I believe, is a very wrong representation of the career is today. Careers are not ladders. If somebody is telling you career is a ladder, you have to climb ladder, it does not happen. Careers today are not built by moving from one level to another level in a straight vertical line. Nobody who has been successful, including myself, has run a straight career ladder. It does not exist. In future, it will never be possible. Okay. Careers is not a ladder, it's more like a GPS. You know, when you might know where you want to reach, but the road to reach can be different. You know, GPS gives you 3-4 options, isn't it? Right? And it tells you that it can take 30 minutes, 40 minutes. You know, it has got some traffic, it has got some tolls, you know, and you can choose how to do it. Because if you don't want to pay a toll, you want to go with a road that is very congested, a lot of traffic might be. But if you enjoy a long drive, 80 kilometers, you want to pay toll, go by the highway, you can do that as well. So there is no one way of getting there. There are different ways of getting there, right? And why it is again a GPS? Because during the journey, the GPS also will tell you that, you know what, I have changed my mind. You know, there is a lot of traffic. There is a political procession going on, and there is a roadblock. Do you want to wait for an hour, or you want to take a different route? So careers are like that. Okay, sometimes you take a different route to ultimately reach where you want to be. I also took a route. I know that I'm recommending it, but when I found an opportunity to move from a hotel management to HR, I actually took a detour. It was a bit of a setback for me, in a sense that I had to start all over again as a fresher in an HR role, but I was okay to do that because I thought HR can give me a right career. So it is not a straight line. It's a combination of horizontal, diagonal. It's more of a GPS than a ladder. Okay. So that is something you have to give, because you know, the options has to be open. You cannot be so rigid. I would only want to do this in my life. Then your skills will get, outdated, and the company you're working for also might get outdated. There is no guarantee, by the way, that the company also will exist. And why this has been important, studies after studies have shown these four things. The skills I am doing, imagine for a moment, I do a very good job in HR, but what I'm doing right now, that skill can be totally non-existent in 5 to 10 years. So I have to rediscover, reinvent myself. Many jobs, my job might not exist in 10 years time. It is possible. I'm not saying it is must, but it is possible. So if I think, I will only do this career ladder, I'll not be successful. And of course, new opportunities come up, new products, new industries come up. WhatsApp comes up, Groupon comes up, Airbnb comes up, Uber comes up, which gives you a lot of good opportunities, right? And that is why, you know, I spoke about this, that, you know, you have to continue to invest on your skills throughout your career. Okay. And look for and take career as a GPS and not as a straight career ladder. Right. So that is the fourth lesson I have learned from my own career, also from the people I have seen growing in their career. Right. This is not find something you will, your typical, you know, career counselor might tell you, or some Instagram guru will tell you, but this is something in my experience. Right. The last but not the least is that when you look at careers, you have to look at it holistically. Careers is not about money and positions. Of course, I get a good salary because of my role. Of course, I am the country head of HR of a Berkshire Hathaway company, which is number 3 company right now, I think, after Microsoft and Google, right? It's a big deal, right? But you know what? This is not the be all and end all of your career when you think about career, right? It is not about how much salary you earn, and it is not about what position you are in. When you think about careers long term, you should think about holistical development of you as an individual. There are 3 things you must not sacrifice on or not compromise on while you are building your long term careers. And I call it the mind, body, and soul development, right? You should not compromise on your body, which is your health. You should not compromise on your hobbies. There are things that you're really passionate about, which gives the creative side of you. It can be anything. Reading, traveling, creative arts, that it is something that you are beside the job that you do. I am a country HR, head of HR, but I'm not the only, this is not the only aspect of me. I'm something else also apart from being the country head of HR of Berkshire Hathaway, right? So That is what I'm saying in mind. And of course, the soul of it, which is like, see if you can give back to the society. See if you can connect with spirituality. See if you can be helpful to others. See if you can do some social service. See if you can make a difference to at least somebody in your life, one person. That is what I call as a holistic development of your personality and your career. With that, that was my fifth skill lesson. So overall, these are the five things that I would recommend you should focus on. This is something that has helped me, something that I believe would help all of you. So that are my five career lessons that I wanted to share with you. Okay. And that, the good news is the end of my presentation. Again, as I said, I would love to be in touch with you. So please connect with me over LinkedIn. I'm also on Instagram, but if you like to read or if you are interested in health, my Instagram account is good. Otherwise, it is very boring. I'm an avid reader. I share my book recommendations on my Instagram handle. So you can connect with me and we can get connected on some common grounds as well. With that, thank you very much. I hope I have not taken much time. And I over to you for any question and answer.
Thank you, sir. It was really a very informative session. And I'm sure students have learned a lot from this valuable session. Now, I would like to invite Professor Iqbal Singh to take the session forward.
Firstly, I would really like to thank you for that wonderful presentation, sir. I'm sure students here today have not only enjoyed this presentation, but have also understood the key factors needed to be successful. I would like to add here, sir, with your permission,
sure,
that success is a combination of various factors. They can be tangibles, they can be intangibles. And I would personally like to thank you for sharing your life examples with us, sir. They were very motivating, and I'm sure they would help students to actually understand life in a much better way. Looks like we already have a few questions lined up, sir. I would, with your permission, I'd just like to ask some of them for you.
Sure.
The very first one is from Shivam. I think it's more of a personal question from him. He says, I'm a very introvert person. What changes do I need to make?
Don't change, Shivam. You would believe it or not, I'm totally, totally, totally introverted. You won't find a more introverted person in the world than Debashish Ghosh. If we ever connect with you and I personally, it is important. There is a certain scale. There's a psychometrical MBTI which measures how introverted you are. Actually, you can measure it. It gives you a score. I'm on the lowest on the score. The issue that people really have, and Shivam, I think for others who are also introverted, I understand, sometimes we feel that introversion is a lack of a skill. So, for example, sometimes people think that because I'm introverted, I cannot do public speaking. I'm just giving an example. Introversion has got absolutely nothing to do with speaking. Speaking is a skill. Somebody who is highly extroverted might not be a good public speaker. Okay. So it has got no correlation to the success or failure of life. Okay. What you need not. So if you're thinking that because I'm introverted, so I cannot interact or I cannot speak or something, there's nothing to do. You just have to put the effort to do it. Come out of your comfort zone, push yourself and come in front of the public and do it. The only way to learn certain skills is to do it over and over and over and over again, right? What you don't want to do is that, Shivam, for you and others, is that you don't want to be afraid of sharing your views. Don't be too shy and don't be so self-conscious that you think that, you know, if I share this, I might look like a fool. I might look like a stupid person. Do not ever think that way. Okay. You should not be scared about or conscious about sharing your views. Okay. That is something you should consciously try. Don't believe that somebody is speaking more. It means they are making more sense. No, you have to speak and speak the right thing and speak to the point, which is typically good introverts do, right? And nobody gives a better example than me. I mean, if I am an introvert, I can move from being a waiter to a head of HR, then, I mean, you guys are much better positioned, by the way, right? You can be a lot better than who you are today. So please be proud of the fact that you are introvert. Absolutely be proud of the fact. There is nothing that you want to change. Just that it should not stop you from building skills. There's no excuse for that.
Right, sir. Thank you very much, sir. I'll just raise my hand and say I'm one of the biggest introverts you can find. I just stay in my zone. Thank you, sir, for that encouragement. Second one, sir, is from Kiran. What she wants to ask you is, what is more important, the IQ factor or the EQ factor?
Both are important. I'm an HR person. I would not ever say that no. EQ is important, and you know, IQ is not important. Both has to exist hand in hand. Okay. What really happens, Kiran? That's a great question. What happens is that as you grow more in your career, EQ becomes more and more and more important, right? Because the wonderful thing about EQ is that while you grow more in your career, the technical stuff that we do, right, that can be done by your team members. You'll have people working with you. You have got team members working with you. They will help you do the IQ part. What you will have to learn to manage those people, you have to have very high levels of EQ, because you're not going to compete with them, with your own team members, you know, with your direct reports on IQ, right? So EQ becomes more and more and more and more important as you grow up. In case there is a study, that's a great book also on emotional intelligence by Daniel Goldman. Everybody have heard about it. 70% of the career success, 70% is on EQ. But that is as you grow. But other 30% also is important. Secondly, this very important point, and I'll make it, keep it short, is that the wonderful thing about EQ is that, and that is why I think the one key difference lies, studies have proved, scientific studies have proved that beyond a point, you cannot build your IQ. If you keep practicing maths, you would not get better, by the way. You will actually get worse after you are 35, 40, 50. However, EQ can be increased till your last breath. So the more you work on it, the better, the more successful you'll be. So right now, focus on both. Right? But as you build your own careers, start focusing more on EQ.
Right, sir. Thank you very much, sir. The third one is from Anjali. Looks like girls are taking a leap in this. The third one is from Anjali. Now, she wants to ask, I am very bad at social situations. She says, terrible, in fact. How do I overcome this? I think she's looking more from the networking point of it more than anything else. She says she's very bad in social situations.
Anjali, right?
Yeah, Anjali, sir.
Anjali, join the club. Welcome. you and I can have a good conversation. Neither of us is talking. So, I think, social networking is important. I think one of the brighter side of these days is you can also network socially, or also virtually social, right? I mean, LinkedIn, you know, Instagram and other things, you know, Facebook, that does not let you, or you don't need to be physically present, but still can network. So one thing is that you can be more active on those platforms, especially LinkedIn. If you are socially a bit, if I can use the word awkward, that is fine. You will always get better at it. No worries about it. But at least start leveraging the social media platforms very, very well. You want to be very good at it to compensate for that, right? One more thing is that, the difference between somebody who's not very socially comfortable is that they might not be very comfortable in a large group. So if you put me in a group of 100 people, if I go to a marriage, I really get lost. You know, I always look for somebody I know, my old friend or my chacha or mama, and hook up to that one person and talk to him, you know, because I'm introverted. The other people are more, they are more comfortable talking to more people. The moment they see more people, they get really happy, right? So you can start with this one or two people, work with a small group. And as you get more comfortable, then you start, expanding your network. Even in physically, I mean, only because see, no virtual networking can replace physical networking. Don't get me, I don't want to send any wrong message. Despite LinkedIn or whatever it is still be the second to, actual networking, right? So that is important, but you start small. Don't think about, well, this person has got 100 people in the network. You know, start with one, two, increase your group and then increase further. Look for common interests and then grow on that one. Look for common hobbies of people and then grow. It'll give you a start to discuss on a common topic, and then you can spread your wings further. But this is something that you would want to consciously build on, because this is very, very important, right? Again, there's no question about introversion, extroversion. This is something that you can practice and build. While you are out of that party or the group, you can always switch off and do whatever you want to do.
Very well, sir. Thank you. So with your permission, I'll add a line onto it. I think in social situations, it's more of the anxiety issue that students face.
Totally.
I think it's more to do with mental health with that. Once they're exposed to it and COVID coming up, I think once they open themselves up, they're going to be fine with it. Finally, I've got the last question, sir. Finally, it's from Babita. Now, Babita would ask you to recommend her some books.
My God, it's like choosing my favorite child. Of course, I have one daughter, so that is easy. I don't know, Babita. I wish I could give you, I have a small library, I can give you a tour of that. One book, wow. That's a tough one. Check Mindset by Carol Dweck. Mindset, the name of the author is Carol Dweck. It talks about how it is important to not to really think that perfection is your goal and to continuously improve on what you are doing. And how can that be part of your mindset where you're not really thinking I have achieved everything or I have learned everything, there is nothing more to do, right? So that book talks about how you can continuously improve yourself and build on that. I have been personally very benefited with that book. So you might want to try that. But there are a lot of other books we can chat about someday.
So, as we come towards the end of this presentation, I would like to thank Mr. Debashish Ghosh for taking time out for this webinar. And last but not the least, the students of Himalayan Institute of Technology for joining in this webinar. In the end, I would like to invite our registrar, sir, Professor Sudhir Badola, for a thanks.
So. Thank you, Iqbal sir. Respected Director, ma'am, Dr. Archana Dasola, Honorable Speaker, Mr. Debashish Ghosh, Vice President and Country Head HR, Mercadia, my colleagues and dear students. It was a tremendous webinar today, sir. It was a very great session today. We thank you, sir, for giving your valuable time and sharing your with the students some key facts about building successful career, sir. I hope that your valuable tips will help your student to guide and mold their careers towards true success in their life. I again thank you, sir, and hope that you will keep guiding us in near future. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you. It's my pleasure, and thanks to all students for attending.
I would like to thank you once again for that wonderful knowledge that you shared with us. Thank you very much, sir.
My pleasure.
It was wonderful. It was wonderful. I'm sure students have got benefited by it. I have benefited by the rules which you were telling. First of all, I'll start networking.
Yeah, it's very important.
And the wedding tip was very important. How to mingle. That's what, you know, he has very subtly informed you, told you, taught you. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
My pleasure. Thank you all for inviting me. It's a pleasure. Thank you. Thank you. Have a good day, everyone. Bye-bye.
Thank you.